Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet. This is Ren Dog coming at you from Grand Molehole Station in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. In the previous episode, we were working on the first floor of Mob Castle, and in this episode, my friends, we have got a pretty exciting task ahead of us. And I basically just loaded up Minecraft today. I was doing a little bit of grinding, and I decided that for today's episode, the Cyberdogs and I were going to find a way to get from Grand Molehole Station all the way over to the Mob Castle so that we could connect the molehole to our Mob Castle spawner grinding facility of awesomeness and doom. And man, it is going to be so freaking sweet. Sit back and relax, my friends. I hope you got something tasty to crunch on, something even tastier to sip on. Let's play some Minecraft Survival. Now, guys, I've done a little bit of preliminary prospecting over here, trying to find out what will be the best route to get from Grand Molehole Station all the way over to the mob farm. And check it out. I have just come out in this glorious little bit of jungle, right behind the Nether Portal Temple. Isn't it beautiful back here? There is a little lake down there with a couple of sheep just bathing, washing his disgusting fur. Actually, why is he bathing right now? I don't really want to know what those two sheep have been up to, but it seems like this one is not happy about it, and he's swimming as far away from that one as he can possibly get. I'm not going to ask any more questions. The sheep in my world can do what they please, okay? This is a sheep-friendly place, and we do not judge. Now, let's continue on through this jungle area. And now, the reason that I got so inspired to do this today, guys, is because I realized something. We haven't done a lot of, how do we even call this? I suppose pathing away through the natural environment is one way to call it. We haven't done something like this in a really, really long time. I'm trying to think back to the last time that we did this, and I think it's probably, well, we did map the road from the Molehole Castle to the Cyberdog Drive-In. We did that recently, but that doesn't really count, right? The last big road that we made, I think, is probably the road to the Silkworm Gang Island. I think that's probably right. But we are now, man, we can't even see the freaking Mob Castle from here, can we? Well, there's the Cyberdog Monument, so we know that the Mob Castle is somewhere around here in this foggage over here. So it looks like we're probably going to have to bring this railway line all the way out to this position. Now, what in the jazz is going on over here? When did I put this up? Curious. Oh, I must have collected some wood at some point. Man, I don't know, this tree's just got some freaking dirt growing directly up its butt crack over there, man. That is kind of strange. But anyway, guys, check this out. This is going to be so cool. We're going to be able to build like a really nice little railway line. It's not going to be anything too fancy schmancy, but it's going to be pretty awesome. What I'd like to do is build like a nice little railway line and a bridge, hopefully, that goes across the sort of jungle basin. I think that'll turn out quite nice, right? And then it'll take like a left turn and go maybe through these trees and whatnot to get to the actual Mob Castle itself. I think that'll work out pretty sweetly. Now, where in the jazz was that tunnel? Oh man, I'm lost already in this freaking foliage back here, man. It is dense jungle in here. It's craziness. This is jungle all the way back from when we first started our world too, man. This is like 1.3 jungle action going on up in here. This is craziness, man. But anyway, let's get all the way back to our initial little bridge, and then we can start cracking on with this. Now, guys, I wanted to talk with you guys today a little bit about some things going on in my life. And I thought that, you know, it's been a while since we sat down and had a chat about what's cracking in the life of Ren Diggity Dog. And I thought, hey, let's build a little bit of a railway line trying to link up Grand Molehole Station to the Mob Castle. That'll be a good little way for us to have a chat together and get caught up with what is going on in the life of Ren Diggity Dog. Well, what can I say, man? It is, what, August 14th today, 2015? Month of the Cyberdog is already half a month gone away already, which is very, very sad, I must say. I had an absolutely amazing month. And man, I've come off the back of a July 2015 where I got to go to Gamescom, I got to participate in the NVIDIA GTX Challenge, I got to meet some of my favorite YouTubers, including Doc M and Generic B, Corralis, I'm Andazel, Mr. Tweeday, got to, man, do just such amazing things in general in my life. It was absolutely awesome. I had the best time ever, man. It's probably the best month that I've had, the best real life month anyway, that I've had in a very long time, in many, 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 many years. You know, we've spoken loads about what we did in the month of the Cyberdog, so I'm not going to go over it again. But what I can tell you is that I'm a pretty happy man right now. And I feel very content with what we managed to achieve in July. It was absolutely amazing. But unfortunately, reality is back. Unfortunately, I am back working, back at my job, back doing a 9 to 5 or more like 8 to 6:30. Getting home at around 8 at night in the weekdays. So, you know, even though I had a really awesome July, and even though it felt like it was very, very sweet, and I really did have an awesome time, I got to get back into the grindstone now. I got to get back to paying them bills and to basically just living life, I suppose. And my job is okay. You know, I enjoy my job. I like the people that I work with, and it's not too bad of a job. It's not too difficult to do. I'm very good at what I do. So, you know, for me, it's all right. Of course, what I wish I could be doing is just having another month of the Cyberdog every single month. But, you know, we're going to have to wait for that, man. It's going to take a little bit more time for us to get to that point. We just got to carry on going, keep on motivated, and keep freaking trucking, my friends. And eventually we will get there where every single month of the year we can call the month of the Cyberdog. But I'm back in the office. Just got back from Gamescom last weekend. And so this has been my first week of being back working. And let me tell you something. The hardest thing for me has been resetting my sleep patterns. And what I like to do when I'm working is I like to try and do recording and editing in the mornings. Now, some of you guys who have been with me for a long time will know that, yeah, it's kind of crazy. I'm kind of crazy in that way. I kind of like waking up super early in the morning, like 5 a.m., doing some recording and editing from like 5 a.m. to sort of 7:30 a.m., and then getting ready for work and going off to work. I kind of find that my creative brain works best early in the morning. I don't know. I've just always been that kind of person. You know, like after a full day's work, I don't know, I can record and I'm happy to record, but I just don't feel as inspired as when my brain has like just freshly woken up from a beautiful night's sleep. You know what I'm saying? So I really, really like recording in the morning. The only problem is, of course, that you have morning voice. And so basically what I end up doing is singing. I usually have like a shower and then I start singing. I do like scales, so I'm like do, ra, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, or whatever. And I just do that over and over and over again until my voice like feels a little bit better and feels a little bit stronger. And then I can start recording. Now, usually the problem that I have with doing that is that I wake up my neighbors or I really annoy my neighbors, right? Now, the good news is that my landlady and her son, and for those of you guys who don't know, I live in a house with my landlady and her son. They have gone to France on holiday, which is pretty awesome. It means I'm totally alone in the house right now, and it means that I can make as much noise as I want early in the morning and late at night. I can be recording, I can be shouting, I can be screaming, I can be a singing baby, yeah. And I'm not disturbing anyone, which is so, so awesome. And yeah, I've been making full use of this opportunity, guys. Making as much noise as I possibly can in my videos and shouting and screaming a bit. But that is essentially what is going on in the life of Ren Diggity Dog. As you guys can see, I am trying to map a path to this position over here so that we can connect up Mob Castle to the Grand Molehole Station. And there is a Skelebutt trying to get frisky with me over here. How did he get out? Oh, you sneaky little bandit, you. You sidestepped my ass. Man, take axe to the butt. And I took an arrow to the knee, it looks like it. All right, I think we better go and sleep the night away here, guys. Things are getting a little bit intense around this jazz. And let's just hop through here and go down to my bedding. And we'll get a nap in. Now, in the previous episode, we were working a little bit on the elephant castle here, or the mob castle, which is slowly but surely becoming our mob spawner grinding machine. Looking kind of sweet, right? I was going to work on this sucker today, but I don't know. I just got this burst of inspiration to try and work out this railway line. And you know what? For some reason, I don't know if it's just me. Maybe I'm just a freak. But I really enjoy creating railway lines, and I really enjoy creating like pathways through nature. I don't know why. I was thinking about it this morning when I was waking up, and I think it comes down to my first ever series of Minecraft Survival. Do you guys remember in season one when I first started like venturing out of the Molehole Castle? And I made these roads, right? The road like came out of the entrance into the Molehole Castle. It went down a little hill, and then it turned right and went down to like an adventure pit, and then it went straight all the way to where the Great Bridge is now. Do you guys remember that road that I built? I remember that road very fondly, and I gotta tell you, it is one of the like one of my favorite things that I've ever made for some reason. I just have such really good memories of building that road. I don't know, maybe I'm just weird, but I think I have a thing for roads. It's official. Ren Diggity Dog has a thing for roads. He's a freak. But I tell you what, man, I really love making that road. And ever since then, I have really, really enjoyed like the road making projects that we've worked on. You know, some of the big ones like the road that goes to Dogtown is really, really awesome. I loved making the road that goes to the Silkworm Gang Island. You know, that road turned out to be like way more complicated than it needed to be, right? It ended up having like an underwater tunnel. It had like a little miniature bridge. Oh man, it just went absolutely crazy. But I really, really enjoyed making that road. It was awesome. But here we are making another road. And I think what I like about it is like the challenge of making the road fit nicely into nature. And if we have a look here, we're going to have a bridge that goes all the way through this jungle. We're going to have to make it look really, really sweet. We can't just have like a wooden freaking beam of a bridge just hanging in the middle of nowhere. That's going to like defy all laws of freaking gravity, right? Let's just get the F3 on the sucker. So this is 304X3041, right? Okay, remember that, guys. 3041. 3041. I'm going to have to repeat this to myself over and over again. I'm very sorry, guys. My memory is absolutely terrible. 3041. 3041. That is the jazz. 3041 is the business. 3041. Ring it. Ren diggity dog. Man, I can't even say my own name properly at the moment because I'm trying to remember freaking 3041. All right, let's just get up here. What are we on? 3036. So we need to do a little bit of I reckon what we do is we extend the initial railway line all the way to 3041, and then we just keep it straight. So we don't have to do this weird zigzag thing. So if we go 3040, 3041, baby, there it is. Bam! That is going to take us directly into the butthole of our butthole. Can a butthole have a butthole? Man. That actually just kind of freaked me out thinking about it. Never mind. I'm going to take that question back. Forget I ever asked it, guys. Please do not respond in the comments if a butthole can have a butthole, because that's just nasty. But anyway, what was I talking about, man? Now I've completely forgotten what I was talking about. Oh, yes, building roads. Yeah, I'm not sure why, but I just really like the challenge of building like beautiful railway lines and beautiful roads through naturous areas. I just think it's really cool. It's one of my favorite parts about this game, and I've realized that we haven't done a lot of it recently, so I thought that this would be a good opportunity to do so. Now, let's talk a little bit, while we're talking about what's going on in the life of Ren Diggity Dog, let's talk in a little bit about what's going on YouTube. Or on my YouTube channel. Well, as you guys know, I'm playing Terraria 1.3 at the moment. Absolutely loving it. Man, do I love that game. If you guys haven't watched that series yet, I am super angry with your asses. And I'ma shove this pickaxe directly between the crack of your ass. It's gonna go deep. It's gonna go hard. It's gonna rip some jazz up. Let me tell you. Go watch Terraria. I thank you. But yeah, I'm having an absolute blast playing Terraria 1.3, guys. It is such a cool game. And we are playing, of course, Minecraft Survival, as always. And, of course, we're playing on the Kingdom Craft server with all of the other Kingdom Crafters. So, things on my YouTube channel are looking really awesome. I'm very, very happy with the series that we are currently playing. I'm absolutely loving every single one of my series, really enjoying it. There's just one series that I am missing that I am trying desperately to find a little bit of time for, and that is Modded Minecraft, which is essentially going to take the place of Feed the Beast. I am really, really doing my best to find a slot for that, guys, and I just can't wait to get into Modded Minecraft again. And I'm also doing my bestest to get back into dog mail. I have already collected about 40 dog mails from you guys, and I'm going to start making more dog mail episodes. It's one of the most requested series on my channel. You guys have been asking me for dog mail now for a really long time, and I just can't keep denying you guys because you're all so damn cute. But we're going to try get back into dog mail again, and it's going to be awesome. I'm just literally, as I said, just started work again, so I'm just in the process of sort of resetting my schedule, resetting my routine, getting back into working and making Minecraft videos at the same time. And you know, it usually takes a couple of weeks for yourself to get back into the groove, so to speak. But as far as this survival series goes, we have got a lot of really cool things going on at the moment. And what I have decided to do, and this is a little bit different to what I've done in the series before, what I've decided to do is try and open up multiple projects. I know we don't really do this on the series, right? Like, we usually work on one project until it's finished and then we move on to the next one. But I've decided to try something a little bit different for this particular season. And I'm going to open up 4 or 5 projects that we're going to work on at the same time. And we're going to sort of flick between them back and forth. And that should keep, you know, things a little bit more interesting, a little bit more fun. And of course, it leaves a lot more room for inspiration, right? Because if you take your eyes away from a build for a while, when you come back to it, you're like, oh yeah, I should have done this, or I should have done that, or let's try this, or let's try that. And it also gives me a lot more time to read the comments from you guys who are giving me some really cool ideas for, like, you know, like for example, for block variation in the mob castle. This is something that I spoke with you guys about in the previous episode. By having multiple projects open at the same time, it just gives you guys more opportunity to feedback, and it gives me more opportunity to read your guys' feedback. So at the moment, we've got, now this is another big project that we've just opened. So we have got Mob Castle, the Victorian Auto Farm Greenhouse, the railway line to Mob Castle, and there's one more project that I want to open up at the moment, and that is going to be the Witch's Cave. And a lot of you guys pointed out in the comment section of the world tour video that I forgot to show everybody the Witch's Cave. And that is totally true, man. Oh, the Witch's Cave just got rejected, got left behind in the dust. And that makes me very, very sad, because the Witch's Cave is going to be so freaking awesome when it's finished. So in the next couple episodes or so, guys, I'm going to start working on the Witch's Cave also. And it's going to be absolutely awesome. At that point, we will have 4 big projects open at the same time. And those 4 big projects should probably take us pretty close to the end of season 4. After all, we only have another, 48 episodes left before the end of season 4. And those are 4 pretty beefy projects that we need to work on. So I'm confident that that'll be a lot of awesomeness, a lot of awesome fun. Although this build itself is kind of getting to the point where it's almost finished. It's just going to be quite a lot of grind work to do. What we're going to have to do is, like, set up the other floors of the castle and turn basically 3 out of the 4 floors into dark room spawners. And a lot of you guys have given me some really cool ideas on how to do that. In the next episode, I think we'll explore some of those ideas. It's going to be really awesome, and I think it's actually going to work pretty well, guys. And you know what, a ton of you guys out there have been giving me some really cool pointers on how to variate the blocks in John Smith. And check it out, man. We can do stuff like this. How did we do this again? Oh, wait. I think what we have to do is a little bit of this action, right? We can cook down stone bricks into cracked stone bricks, I believe. And I think we can also make chiseled stone bricks somehow. Hang on, what is... cracked stone bricks are these suckers. So check it out, man. This is a pretty cool little texture that we can get to help variate the walls. Let's just get it over here, for example. Boom. Look at that. adds a little bit of a nice little cute little detail there. That looks pretty awesome. And then I think what we can do is, do we combine crack stoned bricks with... No, that's not how we do it. How do we make chiseled stone bricks? What in the jazz? Oh, there we go. Of course, we use stone brick slabs to make chiseled stone bricks. Damn, I'm such a noob. Check it out, man. That is actually really cool. Look at this block, guys. Oh my goodness. Have we just... Boom! Oh, baby! That actually works. That actually works quite nicely, doesn't it? I think we have to be quite smart with the placement of it. But I think I may have just unlocked some awesomeness that I had that I didn't think about before. Look at that! Oh, that is awesome. I'm loving that. Actually, let's try something like this. Is this going to work better in this position over here, perhaps? Let's try it out. Instead of the polished andesite. Nah, that doesn't quite work so nicely. But that works very cool. Oh man, this has just opened up a vast freaking influx of ideas into my brain here, guys. This is so awesome. Thank you guys so much, seriously, for giving me these ideas. Because I wouldn't, like, I know that the blocks are there, right? But because I've hardly ever used them, I just don't even think about them. So, it's really awesome that you guys remind me of these awesome blocks that exist. Look at that, man. That's so cool. I think that's cool. It kind of adds a look. Maybe it doesn't really work in these sort of wall areas. But I do kind of like it in these positions like this, right? I think that works quite nicely. Just randomly every now and then. Oh, and another really cool idea that you guys gave me was using stairs and slabs to like create a broken brick, I believe is how you guys describe it. Let me show you guys, man. It looks so freaking awesome. So let's just make one of these stairs like this. Mm-hmm. And check it out. Actually, this is what we do in Kingdom Craft quite a lot. If we add just like a broken stair like that. See? That looks really awesome, doesn't it? Of course, what we need to do is probably make sure that that back block is made out of stone. But there already we are adding like a nice little bit of variety into the otherwise solid stone brick texture. Man, that is so sweet. Man, you guys are the freaking best. You know, guys, sometimes it really blows my mind how ridiculously awesome your eyesight is. I don't know how you guys spot these things, but one of you guys spotted that there was a missing polished diorite block underneath that pillar and underneath this one too. No idea how you spotted that, considering there was just a tiny little bit of it showing, but you guys are freaking amazing, making sure that my world keeps beautiful, man. I love you guys for it. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna experiment a little bit more right here on the first floor of the Mob Castle. I do hope you have enjoyed this episode of Minecraft Survival, and I do hope you are looking forward to us building this awesome little railway line that is going to connect Mob Castle to the Molehole Castle. It's gonna be absolutely awesome. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, you hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, well, we've already had a discussion about your butt crack and a pickaxe. You hit that freaking subscribe button. You hear me, you bastards? I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye, my friends.